will bring all of family to celebrate the Harvest Festival in KDCA Hall. So when we reach there, we were welcoming by traditional musical instrument, which been played by a group of people. It was so loud, but yet enjoyable. On the other side, they have several cultural village, which is represented a multi-race in Sabah. I get distracted when suddenly I heard, "Pull! Pull! Pull!" I ran to the area. That time I saw my father was competing a tug of war with a group of people. So I'm like so excited. I shouting my dad's name. And after that I shout, "Dad, come on, pull, pull, pull." So after the competition, tug of war is finished, my father bring us all over into KDCA Hall. So inside there, when I enter, I saw a group of beautiful ladies competing a beauty pageant, which is called Undung Adat. Good afternoon, Pilotus Master and guests. Today, I would like to introduce Undung Adat, which is actually we celebrate in this month of May, end of month of May. So I have 3 points here. One is, what is Undung Adat? Second one, who is competing in Undung Adat? And the third one, what are the contestants is rated? So come over to one. First point, what is Undung Adat? So first of all, I would like to ask everyone here, does anyone have an idea about what Undung Adat is?
No.
Okay. Well, based on Wikipedia, Undung Adat is actually a beauty pageant. Beauty pageant held annually during Pesta Kaamatan, which is we celebrate in month of May. Undung Adat is actually give a respect to a lady called Hominodun. Hominodun was the daughter for Kinorihingan, the father, and Sinomidun, the mother. Kinorihingan, the daughter, was sacrificed to save KDM. KDM stands for Kadazan Dusun Murut Community, back olden days, which is starving at that particular time. So when Hominodun was sacrificed, her spirit called Bambarayon was called upon and that particular day paddy was planted upon the land. So the paddy actually, that plant when they are the paddy plant, that her body actually was buried there. Ever since, the paddy was a very important food for Kadazan soon, moral communities. That Harvest Festival is held as a thanksgiving for Kinara Hingan and prosperous and generous crop yields. So come to the second point. Who is competing in Unduk Ngadau? But this guy's really excited to know this. Okay, who is competing? The contestant should be in Kadazan Dusun Muru race. See? Single and at the age of 18 to 25 years old.
Wow. 18 to 25.
21.
Oh, young.
Sorry, 25 years old. 25. Contestant made to able to speak in mother tongue language, which is Kadazan Dusun Muru language. And she has to be not a Muslim also. Contestants are compulsory to wear traditional costume. It's costume during the event, so that they presented their own traditional costume of their district and other district. For the third point, what is how is the contestant being rated? Contestant being rated based on intelligence, beauty, their traditional costume, and also they're able to speak in their mother tongue language. They also before the finale event, which is on the 31st of May, they will have a gala night day. So the title for Miss Gala Night, Miss Personality, Miss Friendly, and also Miss Finally, for me personally, Unduk Ngadau Queen is the one who carries the responsibility to present the personality of Hominodun, who is deemed to be a young virgin who has all the good qualities of a lady should ever possess. She is not only presenting the beauty or gratefulness of Hominodun, showing a good example to the society or become the role model of the younger generation, but play her role to help Kadazan Dusun nourish society in appropriate way. For instance, involving in non-profit event to help the needy or promoting and preserving the KDN culture. Thank you.